are about to enter their seventh day of deliberations, the Aaron Hernandez murder trial. A big question, what's taking so long? Are we headed for a hung jury? Joining us to talk about this, Paul Callen, CNN legal analyst and former New York City homicide prosecutor, and Midwin Charles, a criminal defense attorney. Guys, I want to break down the big questions here. Really, the biggest question right now as we head into the seventh day is, oh, he's flung it right off the screen. There it is. 6 days, no verdict. Paul, is there any explanation right now other than this is a hung jury?
Yes, there is an explanation. And I think that it's deceptive to think that they have been out this long in the sense that it took almost a day to a day and a half before they got all the evidence into the room to look over. The court was very unorganized about getting the case to the jury. A couple of the days have been half-day sessions. So I'm thinking it's not really 6 days. They've been deliberating a lot less. It's a complex case. I still think there's a possibility of a verdict here.
Yeah, but, Midwin, definitionally speaking, don't we know that there is at least one person in there, if they've been taking polls, that says not so fast?
It's possible, but Paul's right. I think the administrative process of all of this really boils down to just about 27 hours of deliberation. So it's still pretty early in the process. But if I'd have to guess, I would say that this jury is struggling with motive. Mm. The prosecutors never proved it. They don't have to. But juries like to know, why is it that I'm convicting someone to life without parole or life with the possibility of parole after 15 years? Those are the two options
that
they're facing.
So, Paul Callen, what about the prosecution? This is the DA here. One of the big charges has been they were out-lawyered. They did not prove a motive. At the end, the defense presented this possibility that, yeah, Aaron Hernandez was there, but they didn't pull the trigger. The prosecution outclassed here?
They have been out-lawyered. I think people who have been watching the trial closely have said this is a superb defense team. They took what looked to be a very strong prosecution case and picked it apart, making it look like there's reasonable doubt. However, what I've seen for the most part in cases, when a jury sifts through the evidence long enough, a lot of times the truth emerges rather than the good lawyering. So I wouldn't rule the prosecution out, even though I think the lawyers on the defense side have done a better job of presenting their case.
I mean, we keep hearing this is all circumstantial. This case is purely circumstantial. We're hearing that now. When this all happened a couple years ago, it seemed, oh my goodness, there's all this evidence here. Aaron Hernandez was there, and not only that, there are a couple other murders that he's allegedly connected to. What happened?
You're right, but you see, you made an excellent point in your question, which is there's all this evidence. It's circumstantial, which means the jury has to sort of sift through each and every testimony. They've heard over 2 months of testimony. So they have to go over the testimony, they have to go over all the evidence, the exhibits that have been entered into evidence, and decide whether or not it adds up to a conviction beyond the reasonable doubt, which is a very, very high threshold for them to meet.
You know, Paul, one of the interesting things here is that I'm a Patriots fan, right? And I actually, at this point, don't remember Aaron Hernandez playing that much. His actual play on the field doesn't come into my memory anymore. There was this notion, is this going to be a celebrity trial? Does the celebrity factor weigh in here? Do people still care, do you think, in that jury room that he was a star for the Patriots?
Well, you're a typical Patriots fan. You're trying to forget about him now. But he was a major contract player.
But do you think they're looking at him as a celebrity, as a star, when they're in that room?
Yes, I do. And I think there's this, you know, I've been involved in some high-profile cases through the years, and the thing that I have always noticed is that jurors look at famous athletes in particular, and they say, he's rich, he's famous, he must be smart. How could he be stupid enough to do a killing like this and throw it all away? So I think that factor sort of looms over the case, and I think he gets the benefit of an extra doubt with the jury because of his fame.
Midwin, quick last word on that?
I think Paul's right. Remember, Aaron Hernandez had a $40 million contract at the time that this killing of Odin Lloyd occurred. So he's right. Why would he do this? Why would he risk such an excellent career and so much money? And the fact that they haven't given them any motive to work with, I think, is probably what they're struggling with.
Heading into day seven right now. Could today be the day? Paul Callen, Midwin Charles, thanks so much.
Thank you.
The good stuff is next.